honestly?
Come anytime.
And you said what colors you asked for?
I don't know.
Because you listed three favorites, right?
Well, I like pink and sky blue and turquoise. Those are my three faves.
It's a little turquoise.
Yeah, there's something. Well, I think the pink's in there, in my basket. All right. How are you doing? What's going on? What is going on, Corey? I don't even know.
So I'm going to be super transparent, first of all.
Please do.
On a profoundly human level.
Yes.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
This is fucking awesome.
This is cool.
I was so like, obviously, us nominees are sitting fucking watching the entire thing. And I was just like, because like, look, it's not like I'm making deals with everyone. Fucking obviously not.
Right, we've been here for 5 seconds.
Exactly. We've seen everything everyone's done.
Right.
Charades, fucking whatever.
Yeah.
But I was like, if this person wins, I'm good. If this person wins, I'm good. If this person wins, I'm good. I was so happy when you won. Not because you owe me it. Nothing like that.
Of course.
I was just like, I feel so comfortable having this conversation
with you. Yes.
Whereas like, I'm not going to say a name, but like, it's intimidating shit. You know what I mean?
It's just, this season is very... Like this cast,
yeah.
There's a lot of wild cards. You don't know,
dude. I know nothing.
And here's the thing, me either. And here's the thing, and that's why I wanted the HOH because I didn't want. Here's my thing.
Let's
get cozy because here's my thing.
Mm-hmm.
So, I'm struggling right now because this has all like logistically gone backwards.
Yeah.
Noms were named before the HOH was named.
Yeah.
No game talk has happened as far as I'm concerned, as far as I've observed.
Of course.
Or any, like, significant, like, anything solidified, nothing. People have literally been mingling and, like, getting to know each other.
Like, there's nothing for you to make your decision.
Everyone's just, like, friends and eating dinner together right now. And, like, now the HOH has happened, and I feel like everyone's like, whoa, my God.
Of course.
Like, here comes the game. And in my eyes, I'm like, I just love everybody. And like, it sucks that this is even a situation.
It's so sick being in your position, and it's so fucked being in your position.
Right.
And,
like, it's a tough go for me because I just like have everyone's best interest. Like I just want everyone to be here for the whole summer and just all of us have fun and dance in the room, whatever. But that's not reality.
Of course.
And like, so where I'm at right now is like, I'm just trying to have conversations with everyone and like feel it out and like see where people are. Like I'm a very intuitive girl.
Yeah.
And like, I know when people are messing with me and when people are being honest.
Yeah.
And you're a very genuine person.
I appreciate that.
And I know that. And I want to move forward with people who have my back and I have theirs. Mm-hmm. And I don't want any wishy-washy. I don't want anyone flipping when things go downhill. Like, I want a solid relationship with the right people.
Yeah.
And I want that to be how this game goes. And that's why I was like, I need to win this HOH because I want to set that tone in the house this
Everyone has to come to you and have these conversations.
Right, and that, and I kind of hold the cards as to, like, what happens. And, like, I at first was really uncomfortable with that because I was like, I don't want to come in guns blazing. And, like, again, you know, the odds are, like, this is just, like, historically, like, the odds are kind of not in my favor. Like, I'm a girl coming in, and there's a bunch of, like, jocks in here, and, like, people look at me, and they're like, this pipsqueak, like, she's not going to do anything.
Did Luke say the comment to you?
Yeah. Did he say it to you, too? He was like, I'm not losing her.
Multiple times. And my whole thought is, like, first of all, national fun. Like, what the fuck is that?
Yeah, that's, like... I think he, like, didn't mean...
I don't think he was saying... fuck women.
Yeah, I don't think he was saying that, but, like, I think it was, like, one of those, like, senseless, like, you did not think before you opened your face.
It was just, like, because it was literally, like, minutes after.
He was like, I can't, like, he was like, I'm not losing.
Like, I could lose to a fucking 5'7", nothing. A woman?
Yeah. How dare. Like, I would never lose to
a woman. I'm glad you said that, because, like, it...
Yeah. I picked up on that. I was like,
It really stressed me out coming into this house, because, like... And usually, it sometimes differs, but, like, you kind of have the cool kids, and then you have... the outcasts, and often the outcasts are like amazing people, obviously.
Everyone is amazing.
Right.
Yeah.
I do not feel like a cool kid. But also, I think I'm
You need to know that, though.
Like, I appreciate
In my eyes, you are cool. Like,
and
you're cool to me.
And here's my whole thought is this, right? I'm saying this understanding the convenience of you being the HOH. Like, I get that. But like...
do your thing.
My thought is put all my trust just in you as a person, give you all my... because the people who, like, I vibe with were the people last night who were just kind of, like, hanging out in that area. Like, I feel like I vibe super well with you. I think the Nashville shit, it doesn't feel like it. We're the youngest fucking people in the house. It's an old house.
It's an old house.
And I'm kind of, I don't want to say I'm nervous because I don't think they're sitting there strategizing, let's get out the young. That's not happening. But, like, it's an old house. And, like, you're 24. That's still a good bit older than me. But then there's, like, a couple 25-year-olds, maybe?
2 days 24. But, like, still, I understand.
It's been a big 2 days, to be fair. So my thought is, like, I feel great about you. This is just a personal thing. This is in the case of Vanderbilt. I don't know if you met, like, Vanderbilt guys. It's kind of a... They're kind of, like, douche bros, but at the same time, they're, like, nerds because it's fucking Vanderbilt.
Yeah.
But, like...
You're all really smart.
I tend to get along with, like, girls and nerdy guys.
Yes.
Better.
Yeah.
I feel, like, I feel great about you. Blue is super sweet.
Awesome.
America.
Yeah.
For Jag, fucking hilarious.
Yeah, Jag.
Cameron's the
Jag,
sweetest.
Jag is my dude. I love dude. Jag.
I feel like
I want to work with him.
I feel like he's like I feel like everyone thinks he's his like he's just
everyone,
the nicest guy.
The nicest guy ever, and that's a good person to have on your
team. It's so boring. He's so fun.
He's so fun.
So my thought is like it's not like a sick shit. Like of course not. Mm. But like I feel, and I don't know if you feel this way because you put on a face of like I'm having a great time. It's Big Brother, whatever. This shit's stressful.
It's very stressful.
Like, for you, it's HOH nominee.
Yeah.
And like. I just want to be around people who I feel fucking comfortable with.
Me too.
And like a very vulnerable.
No, absolutely.
Yeah.
Please always come in here and be vulnerable with me. Like I want you to feel like you have a person to come to and talk to because. Hello.
What's up?
Oops.
Is it locked?
Hi, besties. No. No.
What's up?
We're just having a little chit chat.
Can I?
We'll be very secretive.
Very not private.
Top secret.
We'll, I'll be in the non-nethers.
We'll call for you. He's a great dude.
So,
but, so basically, my thought is like this, right?
Yeah.
I want to be in the house on like a very primitive level, just like people I like, people I can vibe with, people who make me want to stay in the house, right? And it's hard because, like, the Nashville thing, it feels little, but, like, there's so little to fucking grasp onto with so many people in this fucking house. Where it's, like my first instinct is, like, Luke's from Florida. Mm-hmm. I'm like, that's my guy. I very quickly found out it's not, probably not my guy.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Very different.
But, like, when you're talking about, like, fucking where you work and you talk about, like, it's just...
The connections you have with
people. Dude, like Red. Red is the coolest guy I've ever met. I have fucking nothing in common with Red.
Yeah, but you know, right? Sometimes it's the people you just
don't.
Like, you think you're gonna be best friends with somebody just because you play the same sport, or you live in the same town, or like you went to the same school, or you like the same football team, and it's like, oh wait. They like open their mouth and you're like, never mind. Like, it's all, that's why I love this game, because you can meet, everyone's from a different walk of life. Different age,
different
background, different family, different lifestyle, like different state. That's why I love it. Like, you can be best friends with someone you would never like ever think to like approach, and like that's the cool part.
And like think about after the show, fucking go whitewater rafting with that guy and go to the flute.
100%. Like that's what makes me like that's and to me I'm like yes we're all here because we want to win a lot of money and like we want to win as Big Brother, but like at the same time I'm like I really genuinely care for people and like. I would hope the same in return, and like, I'm not gonna be a little sneaky snake. Like, that's not the kind of person I am, and like,
you don't seem like it.
I don't want to play without integrity, and like, that's the thing. Like, coming in here, I was like, I want to be myself. I want to play honest. Mm-hmm. I want to work my butt off, and like,
keep. You've done that so
keep
far.
The right. I gotta have to. I mean, I want to be in here with the right people who like.
Yeah.
Don't mess around. Like, I want to cut out the BS immediately, and I want to be the one to do it. I know you're not going to talk to anyone about this. I have a general idea of what I might do.
Okay.
But it's also, like, I want to do it, like, literally 6 hours ago, so, like...
Things can change.
So things are going to change, but, like, I want you to know that, like, you are not... Who I want to leave.
Okay, right now. Very secretly go for a hug.
Yes.
Because I don't want to.
Yeah. You know what? You've had a really rough go.
Dude, the fucking highlight of fucking really summer.
I'm sorry.
This was cool, but like, you winning the competition. Because, like, look, it was never about, like, there was no one who I thought would win who I'm like, oh, I'm fucking golden. Right. That's my final. Like, this is the most. I think I've had one other one-on-one conversation, and that was because we were both in the fucking have not room, right? And I apologize if this is, like, forward or whatever, but, like, I feel like so far you are my person, right? And like, I really do feel that way, and I like, can't promise you fucking enough. I'm not saying that shit. I have to imagine alliances are being made. They have to be. I know the fucking shit.
People are talking, especially today, people are talking because everyone's nervous because I'm up here. And when I'm up here with somebody, everyone else is like, what's going on? Because that's how it goes, and everyone's paranoid now because everything happened in reverse, and we were in La La Land for 20 hours, and then, boom, we have HOH, and now things are happening, things are flying. And that's why I just really wanted to win this one because I was like, I want the right person with the right mindset to set the tone for this summer. I wanted to be the one to do it because I play with integrity, I care about people, and I'm not stupid. I think a lot of people think, not everyone, but a lot of people look at me and underestimate me.
It's hard to underestimate.
Think that I'm oblivious and I don't see things and I'm not intuitive. But someone can look me in the face and I know when they're telling me the truth and when they're not, and that's my superpower.
That's a fucking useful superpower.
Very, very much so. And I think right now, like, I have a very solid idea of who needs to go. Mm-hmm. And I want to make sure that happens.
Okay.
Whatever takes.
I understand, like, it's very scary to give that information so fucking early in the week because, like, there's so much chaos
that can happen.
But, like, I want you to know that, like, and I hope, I know this might be awkward, but, like, I do feel like, to a certain extent, I like, owe you. And I know because it's like we're just working together and I get that, right? But, like, the summary of all of it is, like, how can I fucking help? Because in my head, at least, what's good for your game is fucking good for my game.
Right.
Right? Because we're not a fucking pair or any bullshit like that.
Right.
But like...
But this is a situation and we have to get through it.
Do you know what happens if you go out? I'm fucked. Right. Like, that's just the reality. Right. Right? Exactly. And I feel like...
No, it's a... You scratch my back, I scratch yours. That's how it goes.
And look, maybe I haven't shown it so far. I do think... Competitions, I think they should be all right for me. Like, at least the quiz type of stuff, the puzzle type of stuff.
You're a brainiac. And you are. You're a smart person, and you need to own that.
Dude,
that's
kind of pissing me off, the amount of people who are, I think, underplaying their knowledge of the show. And like, I'm going to be... Because, look, the last thing I want to do is shit talk Suri, because... literally idolized her for 20 fucking years. I'm 21, by the way.
Suri's awesome. But
like, she's told me she's never watched Big Brother. Bull fucking shit. You're telling me you've gone on Survivor 4 fucking times. You're like so into this universe, and then you get asked to do the show and you don't do your fucking homework? I have so much faith in her that she's so much smarter than that. You know what I mean?
She's just very smart.
And that's so, like, that's why, like, and also, like, look at me. Like, if I came in the house and was like, you know, I've never seen the show, would you fucking believe me for a second?
Mm-mm.
No.
Are you a big fan of the show? No one comes in here. Oh, yeah. I know this show. Dude. I'm not afraid to tell people that. Just because you're a super fan does not mean that you have, you know what happens, but I'm sorry, it's season 25, and did I know that this nomination thing was going to happen before coming in? Did I know that this HOH was going to be this HOH? Nobody did. Mm-hmm. Doesn't matter if you've watched the show every season or you've never...
talked about me, my brother, like, whatever, first of all, which is silly, I know.
Silly.
But the main thing is, like, I feel like you can pull some bullshit about, like, oh, he probably, like, knows Big Brother players. Because, like, my brother is fucking, for a 17th placer, he's so fucking active on social media.
Oh, of course.
He's, like, he's Mr.
It's CBS.
CBS
wants to hear one of these shows.
Am I a super fan? I don't know the fucking terminology. I'm probably right. I know a lot about
the fucking show. We fall into a category, yes.
Sure.
We watch it frequently.
Yeah. Like, we could go player for player.
Mm-hmm.
But Zach is, like... on, like, you know, Rob is a podcast. You ever heard of this?
Boston Rob?
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's he's been on these, but, like, he's all over the fucking place. I'm sure he's probably, like, on a fucking live feed update tomorrow morning. So, like, I almost feel like it's so intimidating just in the sense of, like, any fucking random ass leg up and, like, oh, did this guy talk to other fucking players?
Yeah.
I didn't want to fucking get off the show. I didn't tell anyone.
Yeah.
I didn't tell my brother for a long time.
Yeah.
So, like, it's just been this thing because, first of all, no one's going to look at me and be like, wait a minute. He looks like...
You're his brother.
He looks like the brother of the 17th person on Survivor 2. Yeah. It seems unlikely, right? The
That's kind of crazy that Suri is.
Dude, there was a moment when I was, like, talking to her, and I was like, I should tell her. I'm like, no, you fucking idiot, do not. Because, like, when you talk to Suri, all you want to do is, like, basically do what I'm doing in this conversation and be like, you are my person, and we are going to the end.
Her and Felicia, I love.
They're so sweet.
They're the best, and you know what? Mm-hmm. I don't mean to cut you off, but I just want to say, like, and they're smart women, and they are loyal. They're loyal to each other, and they would be loyal, like, to me.
If you want to do that, kind of.
And, like...
I have a really... It's hard, because I don't know what it means if, like, I say I have a good relationship with Suri, because, like, I feel like she has a good relationship with everyone, but, like,
But not a close one. Not a close one with everyone. She's close. She's close with Felicia. She's close with you.
Is she close with Izzy?
Yes.
They seem buddies.
Yes.
Dude.
And I love Izzy.
Massive fucking fan. That's the one, like, one of the other people I had, like, a...
I just talked to Izzy, too. Izzy's on board.
Dude, this is a fun fucking group.
Such a good group. And that's why it's so...
I've never seen this type of shit on Big Brother. Because it's always the same. Like, it's always fucking... And I don't mean to, like, shit on these people, but, like, you know, Luke, Matt, America, maybe you'd be in that category if you chose to, you know what I mean?
Yeah, what category?
Like, the... And I mean, this is the biggest compliment.
Yes.
The cool kids.
Oh, I get you.
You're pretty cool.
So hey, I just love getting along with everyone. And I think it's like...
So have you talked to them?
Luke and Matt.
More so like Suri and...
Suri, no. So Suri and I haven't talked yet tonight. I've talked to Felicia. She actually came to me first. She right off the bat was like, listen, girl, whatever you need me to do, I want to stay.
It makes me so happy that you're like team Felicia because...
Absolutely.
Because... When I'm trying to campaign, because it's never really campaigned yet, but, like, I was almost saying, like, the reason why I don't feel that nervous is because I know how the show works, and when you get, like, an older woman, an older dude, a lot of times they just get voted out for, like, bullshit.
For no reason. And because, like, they're old, and everyone's like, well, let's just get them out.
Meanwhile, it's a fucking waste for you when she's actually just, like, a nice
person
who's going to be, and you know,
like, and she's smart as hell.
Smart as hell.
And people underestimate.
She's the perfect combo of, like, smart as hell. And do you think Felicia's gonna backstab you? And if she does, honestly, fucking...
She didn't mean to. Like...
I was gonna say...
She did by accident. Like,
if the season ends with me getting backstabbed by Felicia, I could live with that.
I'd give her a hug and kiss.
Look, I will vote for her. Like, I mean,
absolutely. Because she means well. And she and Suri just need a home right now. They wanna stay in this game. Felicia told me straight up. She's like, I want to stay in this game. However, I have to do it. I want to stay in this game.
Okay.
And I was like, sounds good. Rock on. I'll let you know because right now they're... So, again, I've been observing. And I'm sure you have too because sitting back and observing is the best thing to do the first 24 hours. And there's only one person that hasn't really been doing a lot of observing. They've been doing more talking than observing. And I think you know who I'm talking about. Take a while, guys.
Shit.
Well,
give me the answer.
To them, apparently you're in an all-male alliance.
Is it Kirsten? Okay. That makes some sense, actually.
So everyone I've talked to, I've asked them to guess who that person is.
All-male alliance.
Apparently so. Like, everyone I've spoken to has told me that she has told them some sort of lie about this alliance being formed and this alliance being formed and this alliance being formed. And I'm like, I am not about... quickly spews these random news stories and lies, like, I will cut that off immediately. And that's why when I look at you and I tell you I want a certain person out this week.
Yeah.
And I want to make it happen. And I don't know how to make it happen yet. And that's what this week is for.
Yeah.
But you're not my target.
Here's my concern. And, like, obviously I'm going to push back on, like, the thought of being a pawn.
Right.
It's just fucking terrifying. You know what I mean?
Of course it's awful, because sometimes it's scary. But, like, I would vouch for if I had to do that.
I know, but, like, here's my concern. Because, like, ultimately I feel like you would be able to win over everyone you talk about, Suri, Felicia, Izzy, like, and maybe even... I forget her name. I know her name. It's an awesome name. DJ, mm-hmm. Australian. DJ.
Oh, Cory. What is it?
Okay, but you know what I mean.
God, I love her. I'm so sorry.
I know. She's, and like,
it's Connie or Cory or something.
Here's my worry, right? I do think, like, when you look at the idea of, okay, Cory's from the fucking nether region, there's all of that bullshit to contend with, and you see, I can't talk about any of it, right? And then you have kind of the cool kid brigade, because I've the one guy who's been a little aggressive alliance making, which I don't think you should target him, because at this point I think he's fucking harmless. I'm trying not Isom.
Oh, Isom.
Isom pulls me in fucking minute one and goes, bro, I want to do this thing. Like, I know we can't talk that much now, but like, I feel really great about you. And I think he said that line to 14 fucking people. And I guess not you, but like,
not me, but
I'm pretty sure you had the same conversation with Red. I feel like I almost caught them in that. But like,
I can see, like, I can know what you're saying, because I can see, like, people are like, at first everyone was in the kitchen all together, yeah. And now I'm seeing, like, certain people breaking off, and like, I've noticed, like, a change in demeanor in some people, and like, you know, I think at the dinner, you know, when I like noticed at the dinner table. At the dinner table tonight, everyone just kind of went silent, and I was like, that's the first time we've all been silent in a room together since we got here.
Yeah.
Like, they make announcements and we couldn't even hear them, and now it's like nobody knows what to say.
Yeah.
And it's like people are starting to worry and starting to break off.
Of course.
And that's why I'm like, right now I want the best posse here. Like, I want,
do you
want
to like make it like a thing or more of like a loose kind of...
You know that you should feel okay. You should feel comfortable with me. I want you to be here. I want to work with you.
Yeah.
I have your best interest at heart. I have a certain person in mind that I want
and I
out
think
of
I
house.
I know who that is, but like, here's my thought. I think if it's a me and Kirsten vote,
worst case scenario,
I think it could get very dicey. Just because, again, like, think about last night. Who was hanging out? She gets along well with lot of those kind of, and I don't like it.
Everyone who's come to me today has dropped her name into my hands and said she's stirring the pot and saying a lot of stuff and walking in on a lot of conversations that she has no business being in.
Yeah.
I promise you, people are coming in here and talking, and they're not super pumped about what she's been up to. Yeah. So I know for a fact, worst case scenario, there was a bond situation.
Yeah.
If there was,
yes,
you would not be the one talking to Julie that night.
And look,
you wouldn't.
I want to preface everything with, like, I trust you.
Please do trust
and
me.
Like, I would. I promise. Fight. I am pushing back on this.
Of course, you're pushing back. No one wants
Tara.
Okay. I know.
And like, honestly,
I know. Give me a hug. I'm going to be transparent with you too, because this is like, for me, like, me in my shoes right now, like, I'm like, what the fuck do I do? Like,
I was like, okay, I get along well with Jared. It's kind of hard because we're both nominees.
Mm-hmm.
And really, like,
right. And also, like, people just are not mingling enough, like, in the game way. People aren't talking game. And I'm glad that, like, this is happening now. But, like, this, again, it's hard to, like, play hard at first. But, like, it should have been happening a little bit earlier than 5 hours ago.
Well, thank God we got you to HOH. I know. Some kids, they would just stay down there the entire fucking time in the big group.
No, I'm like popping a squat here. I'm expecting to be up all night talking. I'm literally expecting that because I want people to be on the same page.
So my thought is like a Jared Kirsten, like, nominee pairing. I don't see a fucking possibility where Jared comes home, because like, and I respect Jared. He seems like a great guy. I don't think there's much. Like, I think he's going to go and campaign hard and try to stay. And I don't think he's going to run around and, like, he doesn't have any fucking baggage where I've got this whole, like, other shit. And if this group of, like, Suri and Izzy and everyone we talked about, like, if that is, like, the group moving forward, like, I feel like that's the first time I've been, like, fucking excited in this house. Because, like, dude, every single time, like, the fucking Nether region and then the fucking, I mean, the HOH comp today, we're just sitting and watching. And then, like, dude, I still can't get over the Luke quote. I talked about it so much to the cameras, but, so basically, the point I'm trying to make is, like, I trust you. I trust your judgment. I do believe if I'm going to be put up, I'm going to be at risk. And I'm in this game. For me, of course.
Of course.
I'm in this fucking game.
And I want you to fight for yourself. I'd be doing the same shit. I'd be like, no!
I'm in this game for me. I'm in this game for you. If we want to do this, I would just feel very uncomfortable about being put up.
I completely understand that.
And look, like, it's so hard to give the fucking same premise. Like, I know. I trust you. But, like,
I'm like, hearing you too, and, like,
all I want to do is go fucking all in on this. Because you don't understand how horrible I was feeling this entire time. And, like,
I know, and I felt that for you. I literally just got chills again because I felt that for you too.
I mean, like, up until this fucking conversation.
Yeah.
Right? And all I want to do is just say, like, fuck it. Game is on. We've got a plan. We're moving forward. Yeah. But then if I'm a pawn, it just feels like...
No, there's still that, like, that stupid chance.
And it's just like... And if it comes down to it, I'll fucking deal with it, and we'll move forward, and we'll fucking dominate all these people. Like,
yes.
We will.
Yes. Because at the end of the day, like, I want to be on the same team. I want to help each other. I want to work with each other. It doesn't have to be, like, this big, like, Reilly and Cory are working together. Like,
yeah, the Pink Alliance.
Yeah, we don't need...
The Nashvilleans.
We don't... Yeah, the Nashvilleans. I love that. That's
hashtag
great.
Hashtag Nashvilleans.
but really, though, like, I want you to know, I was waiting for us to have this conversation. Someone's kicking their butt right now. Did you hear that? I was waiting to have this conversation with you because, like, I feel like you got dealt an unfair hand immediately.
It's Big Brother.
It's Big Brother, but, like, that could have been me, and, like, I feel for you because I could have easily been off that. I was about to be off that wall.
Yeah.
Like, and you came in late, and that sucks, and, like, I have felt that for you this whole time we've been here. I just, like, have been waiting to talk to you because you're, again, my intuition. You're just such a good person, and, like, you deserve to be here just as much as anyone else, and, like, I want you to know that, like, no matter what, I will vouch for you, I'll fight for you. There's still how many days till this decision has to be made? I don't know. There's still time.
I think it's tomorrow.
I might be. They might drop
this. Here's my thought. Like, I don't know how many, like, people are coming in and, like, making, like, grandiose promises because it's kind of a fucking weird thing to do.
But, it,
like,
is. People are coming in mainly to, like, check. Like,
am I good? What's up?
Yeah, like, what's going on?
Like,
yeah.
I don't want this to come off, like, the wrong way, but, like, I think if I were to win HOH from every other week starting next week, you are never being nominated to the fucking final until the numbers make it so there's no fucking choice,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
And for me, it's very simple because it's like, I have one person in the house who I have trusted with all the information I've got. Like, this one fucking person, right? So, like, I just want to be very transparent of, like, I understand, like, kind of what you want to do and, like, how this whole, like, big picture, how this whole thing could play out. And I think it's going to make for such a fucking good season.
Me too.
Can you, like, because I can have some nightmare scenarios about how this season could play out.
Yeah.
And I was very worried about it.
Me too.
Frankly, up until this conversation. Because, like, if, and you raised my one concern, and I'm saying this from, like, a place of, if we have this group moving forward, like, you are so obviously a comp beast. And it's probably weird for you to hear that, but, like, you're going to be good at this shit. The endurance stuff, you're going to be great at too. But, like, I could probably be all right, obviously.
We gotta work on your
match. Mm-hmm. Like, none of us could beat them. There's certain comps that are just going to be impossible.
So well, that's why I want them.
She's gone.
I want, no. So here's my thing.
Yeah.
Here, and I want to sit down with this. Right now, you and I, long term, we got each other's back, okay? And overwhelmed, yeah. And whatever, like the first night, like people came to me and were like, "We need to talk," and I'm like, "No." And any conversation I had the first night, honestly, I took with a grain of salt because I'm like, "No, this is just not. This isn't really it." Like, the conversations today, are what mattered to me.
Of course,
yesterday was locked.
Come in.
Is it locked?
Move on.
Hey, what's up? You want to come in? Well,
I'll be out in 5 minutes.
It was like 2 seconds.
2 minutes.
You're good.
I'll be out in 2 minutes.
Yeah, yeah.
Just stay put.
We've talked for like 47 hours.
He could have even been here. I don't care.
No.
So like...
Because he's literally on board. Well, you know, not in front of him. He's on board. So...
I figured like he's the... So like, my thought... And this is like... I say my final plea... But it's not that desperate, I fully understand. It's like, and pardon the self-deprecation, but like, I think if your goal is to get out of Kirsten, right? The one
currently
did not happen is for her to not win the veto, right?
That's what I'm saying is...
I'm thinking, and like, maybe I'm wrong, maybe it's some super mental thing that I would be really good at. I think Jared's a fucking better bet in that type of thing. And that's like...
I know.
I'm speculating.
He's such a... I just get, like, scared about him. I'm not... I trust him, but, like, I feel like he's the kind of person that's gonna be, like, loyal to me. Wait, if I pull him off.
Is there a certain, like...
I can talk to Felicia and see what she says about being a pawn. Because she is, like, whatever it takes, I want to stay in the game. I promise her, like... I'm just trying to think, like, who is going to trust me enough to take care of them in this situation?
I think what we should do, I think either me or you, like, at some point, maybe it's after Noms, talks to, like, Felicia or Suri, one of the two, maybe them together. And, like, because right now I do feel like Felicia must feel ridiculously paranoid because I think she knows her position in the house. It's just, like, historically speaking, it's, like, a scary spot to be in.
Yeah, it's
extreme. I think she has people going up to her.
And I don't want to put her in that position either. I don't want to make her feel like shit the first nomination.
I think if you maybe get, like... And I know you don't want to, like, have a ton of information out there because it's fucking scary. But, like, who's, like, someone who, like, Jack. Like, everyone fucking likes Jack. If, like, Jack goes and speaks to her. Or, like, you go speak to her, I go speak to her.
Speak to her together. I think it would be nice. I want to talk to her separately, but I also want to talk to her, like, with...
Yeah.
With Jack.
I've got a great relationship with Suri. her so much, but, like, if I go to her and, like, relate just as much as, like...
I want to be there when it happens.
Okay.
I want to be present for any conversation that comes from this room. I want to be there when it's talked about, you know what I'm saying?
Because basically, like, I feel like the gist of that conversation is, like, we are fucking keeping Felicia.
Yes.
That's like, the entire conversation.
We're keeping... As far as I'm concerned right now, there is one person that I feel like the house would all agree with leaving. And I feel comfortable sending that person out the door, not because they're not a wonderful person, but because right now they are shooting themselves in the foot, in my opinion. And I don't want someone in this house that's so willy-nilly.
Okay.
I want someone in this house. I want the people to stay that are locked in.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I keep repeating myself and I'm like, okay, shut up.
We're going in circles.
We're going in circles, but like, that is where I'm at. That's the crossroad I'm at. It's like, who's going to trust me enough? Because I can't take three of you off, and if I could, I would.
Of course.
Who's going to trust me enough to sit there and know that I have the votes for them? I will literally, I am in the position this week.
There's just so many days between now and then. You know what I mean? Where it's like, I don't need to tell you how fucking scary it is.
I know.
And I don't know, because obviously people wouldn't talk about it with me. I don't know how big of a problem the nether region stuff is, because Cameron already came and talked to me about it. Like, so what's really the case? It's like fucking infuriating. So like, that is my one.
People are like,
and like, here's the thing about Felicia. And, like, I mean this in the fucking nicest way.
You all love her.
How much I love Felicia.
Yes.
I don't think anyone would vote for her because they are super worried or they don't trust her. They think she's lying to them, right? It would basically be to keep...
Well, she's like our mom.
Of course, right?
Yeah, so that's not the problem.
And this is... And maybe it's all in my head, but I'm concerned of, like, I could see the path for me to go home, even if it's like a small path. The path for her to go home, I just think is not there. But
right,
like,
because I know, no, trust me, I know what you're saying, because you have baggage right now.
Yeah.
That is not your fault, but people are speculating, and that's the name of the game. Like, they took you away, of course people are going to be like, oh, so what did he get? What did he get? Like, he's hiding something, he's a secret. I understand what you're saying.
I think they're literally... What I feel good about is I think on Thursday, they're probably going to tell us more. I have no idea, right? And I think at that point, it'll be very clear. I don't know shit. So I don't think this will, like, hang over my head for the entire fucking season. But I do think that, like, there's so little. Because this stuff you told me about Kirsten, I could see it. I didn't hear any of it. You know what I mean? And obviously, you've said you've heard it from a lot of people, right? So, like, I don't know if there's that sentiment surrounding me whatsoever. And if there is, in those two fucking chairs, not where I want to be. You know what I mean?
No. I don't want to put you there.
But I don't, like, I'm not trying to literally sit here and be like,
I'm
guilting you.
No, I know you're not. You're fighting for your life, and I would be doing the same thing.
Yeah.
You need to know that, like, I am with you. I promise you. Like, I understand. Like, I don't need, like, it could have easily been me in that place, the nether one, whatever.
I don't know. You seemed solid.
Yeah, but I was dying. I was literally like, I was like, everyone probably heard
it. Motherfuckers were talking about, like, they were itching themselves and changing hands. I was like, what the fuck? She was hard.
I literally was like clenching my stomach and like threatening myself. I was like, I'm not letting go of this freaking wall. And I knew if I let go with one hand, then I would be screwed because I couldn't hold 300 pounds with one hand.
Well, look, I'm gonna, obviously, like, I'm gonna leave now because we've been talking for way too long. But, like,
I don't care because I care about you. So, like, I don't care. If we talk, you can come in here anytime you want to, and we can talk.
So my thought for this whole thing is, like, obviously I walk out. I'm literally probably just going to, like, hang out there, say nothing, go to bed. Tomorrow, I think, is going to be the nomination shit.
Mm-hmm.
So I assume there'll be a little bit of chaos along with all of that.
Probably.
But, like, and this is an honest question, like, do you think tomorrow before that time...
I'll have a decision.
Do you think we should check in, or do you think, like, I don't want to just give you more information when it's, like, kind of the same fucking information, you know what I mean?
I think that tonight I'm gonna be up all night talking.
All right.
And tomorrow check in with me. And, like, I need to talk. Yeah, literally just be like, yo, let's go upstairs for a sec.
Okay.
Or wherever. We can talk wherever. I don't care. But, like, oh, I fucking hate this. I hate this. I want to talk to Felicia because ideally I see what you're saying. Because if you look at you and you look at Felicia, both of you are not the target. But I can see why you're like, hey, people might be more apt to vote me out because of what happened in the Netherlands, whatever it's called.
And, like, on my fucking...
And she's, like, the sweetest angel on the planet. Like, no one would ever touch her because why?
On my fucking... Like, dude, if I was the reason Felicia went home, fucking drag me on Twitter. Get me the fuck out. No, honestly, that's how I would feel because I'd be watching the show and, you know, as a viewer, everyone's fucking behind Felicia because...
Because she's
amazing.
I've never
seen anyone like her on this show, especially. Okay, I'm literally just fucking rambling at this point.
I know.
It was amazing talking to you.
Yes, I'm really glad. Okay, just look at me. Take a chill pill because it's fine.
Yeah.
I'm really glad you talked to me. And, like, please come in here. Like, I'm serious. Like, this week, if noms aren't even tomorrow, whatever happens, like, come in and talk with me. Check with me because you have the ears of people that I don't talk to much. I don't talk to Red at all. I don't talk to, who else don't I talk to?
The one thing I'll try to do, and I just want to be fully transparent about it, is, like, I've been buddy-buddy with Suri, and so far I'm basically just, like, fanning out over her, and she's just keeps saying how funny and smart I am, because she's here, right? I'm just going to keep fucking doing that, because, like, if that is the fucking group moving forward... Like, I want us to, like, fucking feel it. But obviously, I won't say a fucking word about anything without talking to you.
Right. I would love the four of us to sit down.
Yeah.
I would love the four of us to sit down. I want... So...
I feel like in the morning.
We can. And, like, sorry to keep you. I know you're, like, don't go to bed. But, like, here's what I'm thinking. Like, right now, numbers. To make what we need to happen, we need numbers.
Yes.
So, eventually, things are going to narrow down and we're going to solidify, like, more of a pack. But, like, right now I'm thinking the one person that I just really don't trust, okay? I just think that right now the arrows are pointing in her direction to, like, leave. I just think that that's something I want to cut off right now, the drama and the weirdness. But, like, moving forward, I don't know who she talks to and I don't know who she has little deals with. So, like, she goes home. Someone comes after me, I want to make sure that we have a well-rounded crew. You have eyes and ears on people that I don't really talk to. I would love Suri and Felicia. I would love the comp piece because I really like Matt. Matt and Luke are a package deal. Need Luke. I need Luke to step in this room.
Thinks he has me in his fucking back pocket.
Has he talked to you?
I literally just fucking follow him around. I'm like, yo. Can you teach me how to do fucking push-ups? Can you do, like, he's literally from my fucking hometown.
Yeah.
Right fucking there.
I can't tell how he feels about me yet.
I can promise you this. If he went to HOA next week, there's no fucking shot he would nominate you.
Yeah.
Because, like, if I went to him and I was like, Reilly says she feels really great about you.
Yeah.
That would be enough for him to fucking, and also.
I need him to get on this couch and talk to me. Like, he needs to stop. Like. Just chilling. He needs to come in here and talk to me.
I don't think he will do it by his own volition.
Yeah, I don't either.
When he says he's not a fan of the show, I fucking believe it.
Yeah, I do too, because he's...
So, like, he's the type of guy where, like, we need him because he's going to win shit, guaranteed. Yeah,
100%.
But, like, even if we're not able to, like, I don't think, like, you want to pull him into, like, the inner circle or, like, all of that.
No, because he is not careful with his...
Oh my god, no.
And that's a liability, and I don't want that.
Whatever tiny influence I have in this house as the fucking Nether Region nominee from hell, I think I do have it on him. Right? I feel great about my relationships right now. Obviously, you, whatever.
Yeah.
I feel good about Suri.
Yes.
I think if Luke won that contest, I was super fucking safe.
Yeah.
I'm gonna be very transparent about Isom. He's the only other person I made any kind of deal with.
Okay.
I think I trust him the least of anyone in the fucking house. I think
he's a
little chaos guy, but he might just be very excited.
He's paranoid. I think he's paranoid and excited. And
he wants to... He's a big fan of the show, even though he said he's never watched it, I think.
Yeah, you never know. People are really good liars in here. I'm a really bad liar. So that's how you know if I'm ever like,
or you're the best liar of all time. It's like one of the two.
Exactly. So, no, I suck.
So, like, the people who I feel like I was rooting for today, you, Luke, him, and I feel like Isom, secretly, I think he's as much of a fucking competition threat as either of those guys. Mm-hmm. That dude is fucking built.
He's built.
And Luke, honestly, he's kind of like a big-ass clunky dude. Like, he's not, like, be great on Survivor. He's comps more. But I think, like, I don't want to guarantee you, because I'm not.
I know, you can't say for others, and right? It's been 5 seconds, so I get it.
I have a lot of confidence that I don't know who they would target. I don't think it would be near you.
I don't think so.
I also don't think Luke has any fucking idea who to target.
I don't think he does either, but I know that he is loyal to Matt, and he's loyal to Jared. They're like, I don't think they have like an alliance, but I know that they're just like the bros and like whatever. And like, that's what Jared said. He was like, the three of us are like hanging out a lot, whatever. I'm like, okay, cool, whatever. That's fine. I kind of knew that was going to happen. They're like the jocks of the house. Like, that's just classic. That just happens every season.
But the thing is, those guys are usually the ones who like are able to like make a run.
I know.
Like, if they're able to stop that and like not.
Not immediately.
We can't do it too early.
But, no, that would be dumb. It'd be stupid to do that, but we need them for comps. We need numbers immediately. And having three solid numbers, because one of them does something, the other two are like, okay.
Jared's a guy who I fucking click with really well. It's just been the circumstances.
I had a long-ass comp with him
today. I was fucking
today.
Waiting outside.
I know.
But like, and I'm sure someone's waiting outside now to talk to you. But like,
Probably Jack.
He's that guy where like, I do think if you and I like put in any ounce of effort, I know he loves Felicia as well. I don't know.
Loves Felicia. Suri. I think he loves Felicia and Suri.
I think he's the type of guy who like, at the end of the day, I don't think he's like bros to the end. I don't know if he's the biggest fan of Luke. I think because he's been very open. Like, it's just been the circumstances.
I had a long ass convo with him.
I was fucking
today.
Waiting outside.
I know.
But like, and I'm sure someone's waiting outside now to talk to you. But like,
Probably Jack.
He's that guy where, like, I do think if you and I, like, put in any ounce of effort, I know he loves Felicia as well. I don't know.
Loves Felicia.
Suri.
I think he loves Felicia and Suri.
I think he's the type of guy who, like, at the end of the day, I don't think he's, like, bros to the end. I don't know if he's the biggest fan of Luke. I think because he's been very open with me, because, like, we have the whole nominee thing where he's basically like, I'm basically fucking terrified, and I'm trying to just smile around the people who I think are in power.
Yeah.
Which... What are we all fucking trying to do?
Right. You know no one wants to leave this house. I'm shaking in my boots for the four of you. Like, I'm shaking for you. Like, I hate that. I was literally on that wall, like, oh my God, I am screwed if I don't win this. Like, I get it. Trust me, I get it. I don't get it because I've never been in your position, but I can just imagine
concerns. Like, so the Isom conversation, he's like, yo, come talk to me. I go talk to him. And he, like, fucking stone faces me. Like, ask me questions, I'm asking him. He gives me fucking nothing. Which is the only, like...
Wait, what?
And look, it's the...
Isom?
Yes.
Who is he working with,
though? I think he's just trying to figure it out.
I don't think he's working with
him. I don't think he's a concern right now, but, like, that was the only time in this house I'm like, oh, I feel like the target.
Oh,
and
no.
I know he's not the guy making that decision. I get
No. He hasn't even said anything to me.
Of course. But, like, that is my fucking, like... That is where all the dread comes from. Because, like, I've seen the show. I'm walking up to him. I'm like, so, who do you feel good about? He's like, I feel good about everyone, you know?
Yeah.
Like, oh, have you had any conversations? Yeah, with a couple people. It's been really good. Like, literally giving me the most transparent nothingness of all time.
Very surface level.
Which is a very safe thing to say. I get that. But I'm all about just, like, if I'm fucking with someone, I'm going to...
Yeah, we talk. We tell each other. We tell each other things, and then we... I don't think, like, just my intuition speaking, and just body language wise, I don't think that he has any real deals with anybody yet.
I think he has a lot of fake deals.
Yes, I think the first night he probably went around and had those, like, hey, like, I feel really good about you, you feel good about me, like, all right, cool, I got your back.
Yeah.
Cool. I think it was, like, that surface level, like, first night, like, okay, like, let's make this bond right now.
Yeah.
Instead of, like, a okay, like, this is the mission. Let's work together. Like, let's shake on it. Let's call it a deal. Like, I don't think it was like that. I don't. So I don't think, I wouldn't be too concerned about him. But also, like, I don't have anything with him. So, like, yeah. Next week, what I'm saying is, like, next week when I can't play, I want to make sure the people that are playing have my back.
Look, I think the great thing about you and, like, especially me with Isom is, like, by you being HOH and him not going home, you've kind of helped him out, even if it doesn't, like, seem that way.
Yeah.
Because, like, you only got to pick out of however many nominees. Right. But, like, I can't imagine he has any fucking reason to look your way or look my way. And I think knowing him...
Unless somebody wins... Unless, like, a nom wins the veto and then I have to put a replacement nom up, like, who the fuck would I put up?
I think you just got to probably just put up a random... I don't know who that random is, but, like, I'm going to tell you my goals leaving this room. I'm going to continue nerding out over Suri because I think Suri is going to feel like
she's close.
I just want Suri to feel like I would never betray her because I idolize her because it's kind of true.
Yeah, but of course, I mean, it's Suri.
I'm not planning on losing to Suri in the finals.
Yeah.
But, like, that's what I'm trying to do there.
Yeah.
And then with the bros, I'm just going to try to fucking fourth wheel as best as I can because they are the bros. But yes. Individually, I get along with everyone.
Totally.
So if, like, obviously, I don't think tomorrow you're going to call in the fucking 8 people.
I can't do that.
That's impossible, right?
Eventually, I need to. No, it's just so hard.
Like, I'm gonna just keep talking to Luke, keep working out with Luke.
Yeah.
Maybe one day I'll be as big as Luke.
Won't we all?
But I just want to, like, that's my plan.
Yeah.
I'm going to keep talking.
Keep mingling. Keep getting people on your side. Keep making friends. Work that social side of things, because as for numbers, regardless if it's you or Felicia or whatever has to happen, that has to be up there because somebody has to, because that's how it has to go.
Of course.
Not that I want it to be that way, but, like, I have to talk to her, whatever.
Yeah.
You have the numbers. Regardless, it's not going to be you. It's not going to be her. It's not going to be Jared.
Yeah.
I'm with Jared. I trust him. Like, when he talked to me, he was like, he pulled me up the block, like, I got you, like, I am loyal, he was like, loyal, like, and I feel like it's gonna take me pulling him off the block for him to be like, okay, this is solid, because we have Jared, then we have Matt, then we have
Luke. He's a scary person, because if he goes and wins HOH next week, and you
he's gonna be like, oh, do you want to be a pawn?
You're like an easy nom.
Exactly.
But, like, you're
and he's capable, like, he's just really capable of that, and, like, be there for me even if I have to do that. And I trust Felicia to be there for me. You're like, I hate you.
Wait, here's look. And I'm never going to condone myself being a pawn.
No, I know.
I know my mom's watching.
She's like, what are your
fucking nails? And I'm just like
sorry, Mom.
I hate doing anything that even resembles saying something bad about Felicia. But, like, I don't think she's very likely to win the HOH next week. I think if it was a mental challenge, she's as good of a chance as anybody.
Yes.
But, like...
a physical comp? Yes, would be...
That issue I see with Jared, I don't see it with Felicia. And also, like, I don't know how... Like, are you familiar with Survivor?
Have
you, like,
yes, you know about I love Survivor.
Do you really?
Yeah.
I am
a reality TV show junkie.
Yeah.
You can tell.
Okay, well, I have someone to nerd out with.
Yeah, totally.
But, like... Suri, she is not the type of person to, like, you fucking don't say Felicia, who's gonna be like, oh wow, I'm gunning for that bitch.
Yeah.
And she starts like, yeah, that is, she is, like, going to play it super cool.
Yeah.
So, like, I will never say I'm okay with being a pawn.
I know.
But I trust you.
I don't want you to be okay with it.
I trust you.
Please trust me.
And
we're gonna talk about it. I'm gonna talk to see what Felicia says, because she talked to me today. She was the first one to walk up to me. She was brave as hell, and she said, listen, I know you gotta do what you gotta do, but I wanna stay in this game, and I wanna play this game, however it has to happen.
Yep.
And I feel like if I talk to her and I explain to her the same as I explained to you,
yeah,
like, who my target is,
okay,
who I would like to leave the house this week based off of the very unfortunately minimal knowledge that I have, like, yeah, it sucks because I haven't even gotten to know everybody yet. Like, that's the part that sucks about this. It's like, oh my God, like, I don't want to be the reason anyone leaves.
Well, honestly, it's nice that Kirsten kind of gave you...
She shot herself in the foot. It's nice. Like, I'm going to capitalize on that because that's smart for me.
And that's not on you. That's on the fucking...
That's on her and, like, everyone. And the fact that everyone has walked in this room today other than you because you're not in that, like, worrying little loop. But, like, everyone that I've talked to today has literally came up to me and said, well, this person, even Felicia said it. She was the first one who told me that she's been spewing. Felicia was literally like, I just want you to know.
In that comics room, in, like, the love room, or that, what is it,
the
scary
room? In the scary room, yeah. Yeah, she came up to me in the scary room. She was like, I just want you to know. And I was like, thank you for telling me that. And then 3 or 4 people came in, obviously, like, talking their stuff, like, doing their thing, fighting for themselves. I get it. Every single one was like, well, just so you know, like, this person is kind of saying a lot of stuff. And, like, I've noticed she's been, like, in here a lot and, like, talking to me up and, like, kind of, like, saying conflicting, like,
honestly, she was the one person you were definitely going to save for the sole reason.
No.
I just saw you guys, buddy, like...
Girls.
Next to each other.
I am confident in myself enough as a woman to not need an all-woman alliance. I am confident enough in my abilities to know that, like, working with men is not, like, an evil disaster. Like, I want to work with dudes. Dudes are smart. They can win cons.
They can run fast a lot.
And they can run, yeah, and they can run fast. And you know what? Like, I don't need to be in an all-girls alliance and, like, prove something to somebody. Like, I want to work with people not because they have... Not because they're a girl, but because I trust them as a person and a player. And that's what I care about more than us all winning because we're girls. Like, I don't care about that. That, to me, is not important.
Yeah.
I'm confident enough in myself and the people I put my trust into, and that's what I'm riding on this season. That's what I want. That's what I want this season to be about. Integrity, honesty, loyalty. That's all I care about.
Yeah.
So, right now, there's only one person that I've seen... One person that has shown me enough that they are not really doing that right off the bat, it's a red flag for me.
I'm a very straightforward person with these things. Yeah. Like, if someone does me a favor, they're getting that favor.
They're getting it back.
Returned to me. And, like, it's one of those things where, like, I just can't fucking sit there in the fucking Jack in the Box bed at night thinking, like, damn, I'm a dick, right? Especially for someone who, like, and maybe it was never actually this way, but I felt like I was in the fucking gutter. And I was, like, pulled out of it.
I saw it on your face.
I've been trying to hide it. It's not been good.
Well, I also, like, am such an empathetic person. And, like, I've been thinking about you since you came into this house. And, like, I just, like, I, like, always want everyone to feel so happy and comfortable.
God, I was so
and, like,
fucking happy when you won the competition today.
I know.
I was.
I knew.
There were only a couple people who I was, like, really worried about. But, like, I was so fucking worried.
I know. Well, I know, and I want you to feel comfortable with me. I want you to. And it's a ball sack of a situation.
Look, I hate it. I'm going to walk out, but I trust you're going to make the right decision.
Yes.
We'll talk tomorrow. I know you
have And to you have, will know before it happens what I choose.
And I know you have to have conversations with a lot of people. So, like, tomorrow, when you feel like, all right, it's time to fucking talk to Cory and maybe, like, Suri Felicia, she fucking tap me on the shoulder. We'll figure it out. We'll get going because, like, I don't want to barge in when you're talking to, like, however many fucking people you have to talk to. You're that girl right now. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So, like, does that sound good?
Yeah, works for me.
All right.
Give me a hug.
Let's do this.
Okay. I want you to breathe tonight. Sleep tight. You're okay.
I'm so much fucking better than I was an hour ago.
Please, I want you to. Okay. Like, I promise you, I have your best interest. Okay. Promise, pinky, swear to God, thumb it.
And I'm just saying, I'm not for naming alliances. It's kind of Nashvillians is not bad.
Nashvillians, I love it. Represent, baby.